Hello everyone, MadHatter7120 here, and welcome back to the magical, awesome, epic that is the tale of Squire Jasper. We are back in Portal Knights, where we are in Emerald Fields, not Hills. And I played a little bit of this on, oh yeah, here's a good example of what I was about to talk about, on a different profile, so that way I could just experience a bit more of what was new. Something that's new, NPCs! Well, some of these people offer quests, and those quests are useful to you because it earns you money and stuff. But the thing that we want here in this world today is to find a suitable home to call, not our own. It's mine! It's my house! Get off my lawn, kids! Hello. Do you have anything you want to do? Oh, shut up! Suddenly, the developers of this game lost points with me because they made that reference to Skyrim. Ugh. This land has so much beauty, so much potential, but now, it's all gone sour. It's all bad. It's all awful. It all needs to be gone. Okay, burn it. Burn it all. And while we're here, we need some, what's it called? Coal. So we're going to be doing a bit of work. I know I said I was going to do the grinding and all that separately, and I will. I do plan on doing all the intensive grinding separately, and then once I have the resources, I'll show you guys the crafting of the finished product. But for right now, this is a big moment, you know. We need to find a nice home. Oh, there's actually water physics a little bit in here. That's nice. Anyway, we need to find a nice place to live. And of course, collect as much gold and jewels as possible. And XP, because for some reason, breaking barrels gives you XP, but I'm not going to question it. There's the portal out of here. Or at least one of the two. This is where you start getting multiple portals per world. I don't know where to go. In my world that I was playing off-screen, I actually built inside one of these big towers here that are right beside me. And I built up this wonderful little, it's kind of, well, it's not wonderful, it's a cute little, barricade to make it look like I'm having a little fortress. It's kind of nice. Don't judge me and my role-playing. So, I might just end up building inside that tower again. But what I like to do is go and claim something like that townhouse over yonder. Let's take a look-see. Oh, and I did take a look, and there are portal, or not portal, things. What are they called? You'll see in a moment what I'm yammering on about. Yeah, right here will do. It's not fancy by any means. It certainly isn't spacious. Well, think of it this way. There's room for improvement. And this is right next to that tower and that odd little church building, so yeah, it's alright. Okay, let's get some lanterns. Bonk. Go upstairs. Bonk. There, that'll do for now. Bop. Give me this. And for now, yeah, put it here in this corner. We need to upgrade you. We have no wood. Booger. We don't need these. We need more wood. Oh, and of course, the christening of our... Don't you disrespect me. I was trying to say the christening of this home as our own by claiming it with this banner. By the way, if you're someone from the future, and you're wondering how the heck I have this banner and you don't, it's because I bought this game in early release, early access, and yeah, I'm a pioneer. That's why I have the cape and the flag to match. So, where were we? Yes. And if you bought it afterwards, then, tough, I guess, you know, you too slow. Good thing I brought a window, because I don't feel comfortable with that thing out there staring at me. I need to fit in this stupid frame. Bless me. The sneezing. I want it like that, or should I put it like this? Let's put it like that. There, now I feel safe. Safe inside my little home. It's beautiful, isn't it? Gotta upgrade the workbench to tier 2. Look how pretty it gets. It gets metal bits. I don't know what I'm on about. Okay, so. Now that we have tier 2, we now have access to finer tools. Copper pickaxe, copper axe. Very good. We also have access to new decorative blocks, but the important thing is, where is it? Ah, yes, the workbench facilities. Archer station is useless to us. We'll want the anvil, the furnace, the altar, the drafting table, and this, the ward of protection. That's what I was on about. This stuff is easy to get right here. Well, it's going to be a little more irritating since we have a copper pickaxe, and in my other world I had iron, but whatever. For now, though, let's just worry about getting the essentials. And we just need a lot more wood. Okay. Space is going to be a wee bit limited for now. So, what I'm gonna do is just put stuff in corners and say, good enough. You dig? You dig? That's fantastic. Great. Glad you dig. And, this has 4 slots, so, you know, just put some junk in there. Actually, give me that back. Okay, I'll put tree seeds in there or something. 3, 4. There. Seeds. And you can have, you know what, more seeds. Have at it. Hey, it's free storage. If it's gonna be there, might as well put it to use. Waste not, want not, as I like to say. Some more wood. That's a big tree. Now it's dead. Nah. Yeah, it's dead. Okay, jump. Ow, ow, ow. Get out of my house. Okay, so let's get a chest on the roll. We'll get an altar immediately after. And we'll get a drafting table immediately after that. And we are out of wood and we're out of copper, just about. So, that's fine. We'll deal with it. So, the drafting table, this is my problem with the crafting table now. The crafting table is essentially useless, because the drafting table does now what the crafting table used to do, which was make furniture. And the altar was always doing what it does now, so that's fine. But my issue is that now we also have the archer station, which is just a shooting range. I don't see how that helps you craft gear. Especially considering there's a lot of woodwork that goes into preparing archer based weapons, considering there are bows, crossbows, and arrows that you need. I'm digressing. My issue is just that now you have so many workbenches, all of them huge, may I add. They're big. So they're consuming a lot of space in all your homes that you have. which in turn then makes the issue of you having too much space and everything being fairly useless. Well, at least this thing is useless. I mean, if it's going to be like this, why not make a loom so that way you can just, instead of having to, instead of going out and needing to come back here to... I'm so confused because everything's making noise around me. Instead of coming back to the crafting bench to make cloth, why not instead build a loom so that way you can make cloth and make, wizard's gear or something like that, I don't know. I feel like they've made too many workbenches that serve too little a function. But whatever. Oh, I thought it was more coal here. Nah. Meh. No coal. Dang-nabbit. Now if you saw that, I'm not an idiot. No matter what my friends and family say. Anyway. Just kidding. Okay, got some tools, fantastic. And boom, this is kind of where I like having things. And this on the fourth slot, this on the fifth slot. This is garbage, you can go away. Oh yes, I need to place down this chest. Put that there for now, it's not very big, but it's bigger than these shelves. This, actually, I'm gonna make more linen out of that, or cotton cloth, whatever. Keep this on me, we're not gonna use those for now. Put those away, this away, blah blah blah, don't need this or that. Actually, keep building blocks on me, keep the ore on me for now. Armor flask, I'll put it away for now, we don't need it. I think this is the essentials. Alright. What? Okay, good. So I'm just gonna make another ingot real quick. Because now we need to think about upgrading. And upgrading we shall do. So. Right. Mm-hmm. So what we're gonna make is this copper axe. And we need a scale for that. That's not going to be hard, trust me. It's there's a desert world up ahead that we can get scales from, and this is the weapon we're going to make. This is also where we're going to make our specific armor. So right now we have the Viking set and the Beastmaster set. Mr. Helm. So essentially we're going to be going with Viking for right now. Because it all seems to be the better stuff. Yeah, it's all the better stuff. So that's the plan. I'll attempt to get, if I can't fit into this episode, which we may or may not, I may or may not be able to do, then I'll do this off screen and you guys don't have to worry about any of this. And then the next episode we'll pick up with me getting all the good stuff, and then we'll move on with our lives. How's that sound? Sounds pretty good to me about moving on with my life. Pretty good. I enjoy it. Okay, so right now we need more coal, because we need to smelt more ores, and we need more ore in general. Thankfully, Emerald Fields is earliest map in which you can get coal, and coal is fairly abundant here. For the most part, we're not going to be dabbling with the arcane bench, for the most part. There is a few small things we could use it for, but largely... Are you kidding me? Erg! Get out of my way, slime! This is bad. I'm so weak. Give me that health. Ow. Evil monsters trying to kill me. K- Can you not? This is why we need the ward of protection. Because these things won't leave me alone. In fact, that's what we're gonna go do right now. Stuff it. Stuff it. So, we need 12 of one type of rock, and 4 of this stuff that's right here in front of us. That's gonna be the goal for this episode. Getting the ward up. Because I've had enough. And yes, it's going to take this long. If you think this is tedious, it is. It's a slightly better if you had this than the other pickaxe. And if I had iron pickaxe, this would go even faster. But oh well. We have to deal for right now. Just gonna have to deal. I'm also gonna need some stone. Not for this project, but something that's coming up ahead. I should do for now. Let's get a little bit of stone. I need some ruined stone, which in my other world, there was a set of... Why are you up there? I get this urge of I should talk to this guy. Hello? Shh. Okay. Okay, I'll do that. Sure, I can kill those for you. Sure, pal. But I can't do it right now. I need to get some nicer gear first. So there should be some ruined stone around here somewhere. Oh, right over here is some ruined stone. And these are 2 stores built right next to each other. And I know what you're thinking. These ain't stores. These be ruins. Well... It would be good of you to just look down here. This guy sells bombs, if I remember correctly. And the other guy? I don't know. Oh, wait, no, this isn't even a store. This is a dungeon. But this is the stone we need. 1. We need 12 of this. 2. Some weird lag happening right now. Ten. 11. 12. Excellent. Okay. There's now... Oh, no, we're good. I just need to craft, boom, 1 of these. And we are golden. We are golden. Just put that here and make a spot in my inventory for it when it's done. I forget where our house is. I know we came from this way. Yeah, the goal of this episode is to get our home up and running. And to just get the ward of protection down. With that in place, we have a nice foundation. I'll go off camera, and I will do all the grinding and all the hard work to get the materials we need to make Squire Jasper here into a proper warrior. And once that's done, then we can just sort of, you know, just go to world, conquering challenges, taking land. You know, all that fun stuff. But what do I need here? Oh, that's right, the workbench makes it. Because, of course, for some reason, the inscribing desk, of course, it doesn't make anything magical. But, oh no, it makes the magical stuff. But for some reason, the workbench has to make this magical artifact that will literally shield me from evil. And now take a look at that. This radius determines how far... The grid is that monsters will no longer spawn. And I'm gonna make sure it's a good distance here. And actually, it should just be right in front of my house. Methinks. Get this stuff out of my way. It's probably just gonna be me some space. Yeah, something like that. Something like right here. And now, right now it's not on. To turn it on, we need one of these, and a line around your home you've drawn. Within it, new foes will no longer spawn. So, come the morn, all these guys will be gone, and they will never come back. So there, safety. So that does it. We have a home. It's in disrepair. Bless me, random sneezing. I don't know why I'm sneezing. Maybe it's because it's early in the morning and the early morning pollen agitates my nose and it agitates my allergies. Maybe. Anyway, so we have secured a home for us that we shall use as a base of operations. It's a little makeshift right now, but this is the beginning of greatness. In the future, when Squire Jasper is known only as Elite Knight Supreme Jasper, will we look back and think, these were the days when we were humble heroes of the Dirtlands, or something like that, whatever. Peasant knights, something like that. Holding a wooden sword and a chest plate and a rimmed helmet, something like that, I don't know. Yeah, my epic is kind of losing track. Yeah. Oh well. So, what we're going to do now is we're just going to end the episode here. I'm going to proceed to go off screen and do all the farmy stuff that none of you want to see. And from there, I'll make a return in the next time. Probably tomorrow I'll record more of this. And, or maybe I'll record more after this, right after I'm done with the farming. You know, we'll see what happens. I don't know, I upload usually 2 videos a day, so, you know, we'll see what happens. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Securing Our Homestead. And I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.